Hello everyone, welcome to the AMC Tech video series. Today I will show you how to use ImageJ software to analyze your SVM images. Okay, let's start from the basic. First of all, you need the ImageJ software. In the description, you can find the link to download the software. It's a portable software, so you don't need to install anything, just extract and use. Let's start. This is your software, just open it. Okay, you can find a simple interface. First, go to File, then Open. Then you can open your SVM image or the example given by me. You can download this example by the link given in the description. First, go through the example one. Okay, this is the preview. First of all, the software don't know anything about the scale, it only knows about the pixels. So we have to make a relation between pixel and the scale. We can use the scale given here. So first we have to zoom it in. Go to the magnification tool. By left clicking on that, you can zoom in, and also by right clicking, you can zoom out. Then use the line tool and draw a line from this center to this center. Right. Now go to the analysis and set scale. Now the software has count the number of pixels between these two ends. Now we have to let the software know this length is equal to 100 nanometers. Okay, give 100 here and keep the pixel accept ratio keep in 1. Then the unit is nanometers. Okay, now you can do any kind of measurements. Just zoom it out. Okay, but when you are going to analyze the particle size, it's very difficult to use the whole image. So you have to filter some specific area out. So I will use the rectangular tool. Then I'm going to select this kind of region. Right. Then go to image and duplicate. You can change the name or just leave it. Okay, here you have the duplicated one. Now you have to make sure, if you are going to analyze a series of SVM image, you have to use the same scale here. Right. Okay, then to analyze the particle size, you can go through two ways, by using the area or the length. Okay, first of all, I will show you how to measure the area of a particle. Just go to the polygon selection. Why we are going to polygon selection? Because our particles are not uniformly shaped. It has very arbitrary shapes. So just you can select the points like that to cover the whole area of the particle. Right. Then go to the analysis and measure. Okay, it will give the area under the selected area. Right. The next way is by using the length. So go to the line tool, then you can draw a line between one edge to another edge. Then again, by going to analysis, clicking on measure, you can find the length. Here length is given. Right. Now what we have to do, we have to measure the all particles covered by this region. Okay. I will do it by line tool. Just I'm going to clear all the things. Okay. I'm going to start. Okay, I have here one. Just measure. Now I'm going to select another one. Measure the smallest one. Measuring. I'm only going to analyze a few particles, but when you are doing, you have to cover all the particles here. Okay, that's enough for me. Now you have the results. Right. So you can interpret your particle size as a distribution or just statistical measurements. First, okay, you can use both. First, I will go through a distribution. Then I'm going to use the length distribution. You can keep the automatic binning, otherwise you can change this, but it's better to keep it automatic. Click OK. Now it will give a histogram of the particle size variation. Since I am going to have few particle sizes, it shows like that, otherwise it will give you a distribution. And also simply you can find the statistical measurements by using summarize. It will give the mean length, which I measured as 114 nanometers. So this is the simplest way to analyze the particle size. And also you can save these files as a result file. It will save as a text one, right? Okay. Now I will show you another one. Okay, I will close it. Now I don't need this one. And some of the journalists, when you publish your result in some journals, they don't need you to put this kind of scales. They need you to put the custom scales. So I will show you how to use custom scale. For that, go to analysis, tools, scale bar. Okay, here you can see the scale bar appears. I want to give 200 nanometer scale. So I will put here 200, and I want to show it on the top right corner. So here put upper right, likewise. But I think it's too much small. So I want to increase the font size to 32, right? And also the line width is not enough, so I'm going to increase it up to sorry, 10 is enough, right? Or otherwise you can use 500 here, likewise. Then click OK. And also sometimes you may have very light background here, so you can't use white at the time. You can go for black, but here it's better to use white. Okay, click OK. At the same time, now you have a custom scale, but you don't need to put these kind of informations, so you can crop that one. For that, use your rectangle tool and select the image up to here. Right. Now go to image, then you can use both these two functions. By cropping, you will lose your initial image, so it's better to do duplicate. Yeah, you can use any kind of name. I'm leaving it here. Right, now you have the image. Okay, and if you are willing to put several SEM images together, so you have to name it. So I will explain how to insert a text in the image. So for that, go to your interface, click the text tool, then click and drag it like that. Then you can put any kind of text here. I will write the image A. Okay, now I have to change the font and other things. So for that, double click on the font. Okay, here you can change all these things. I'm going to use the font Times New Roman. And my font size should be 's enough. And for better visual, I will go for the bold. Okay. Now all things set. Close. Is it finished? No. It's just an interpretation. If you click somewhere else, it will disappear. So, first thing we have to enter your text, and you have to do this fill. So go to edit, fill the interpretation. So now it's here. Okay, that's enough for this video. In the next video, I will explain some surface analysis techniques such as roughness and also the 3D interpretation of SEM. If you have any doubt, don't hesitate to put a comment. If you got something from this video, just give a thumb up and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.